Hello everyone, I am Dr. Vivek. Now I will demonstrate how to use an oxygen concentrator and when to use it and to whom to use it on. Before using it, check the saturation of the patient. This is a pulse oximeter. You have to put it on the finger like this. It will show two values. One is pulse, SpO2, that is oxygen levels, and the other is pulse rate. Oxygen levels should be more than at least 85 to use this machine at home, and pulse rate should be at least less than 110 to use this. If this SpO2 is showing less than 80 or 82, then better to refer the patient to hospital itself. And if this pulse rate is showing more than 120 or 130, then probably he needs high flow oxygen. You know, this may not be enough. So this is one thing that will guide you on how to, on whom to use it on. So this is a concentrator. Place it in a well aerated area, like beside a window or something, and place it at least 1 to 2 feet away from the wall, so that it has air. It has to breathe. And switch it on. So there's a small chamber. You have to fill it half with distilled water or filter water. So that means oxygen that comes through this is humidified. So that is not a dry oxygen. It is a humidified oxygen. It will not cause any cough to the patient. So once you switch it on, there's a meter here which shows 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That means how many liters you are giving per minute. This is 1 liter per minute, this is 2 liters, this is 3 liters. So ideally for all patients, you put it between 1 to 2 liters and wait and watch. You have to put this wire on the patient. This is how you have to place it. This has to go inside the nose. Suppose this is inside the nose, imagine. And just tighten this. This should be inside the two nostrils so that it is fixed. Even the patient knows here and there, there is no problem. This is how you are supposed to use that, and you can remove it like this. This is one thing. This works only till 4 liters. The patient needs up to 4 liters, you can give this. What if the patient needs 5 liters? Ideally, that means he is not maintaining on this. So probably you have to refer him to hospital. But before doing that, if you want to give 5 liters, then you can use this mask. This mask can deliver 5 liters. So you have to remove that and put this mask. So we can put it like this. So you can put this mask like this. So this is how you are supposed to use it. This wire will go in here. You have to put this, you have to remove and put this here. So this is one thing. Always make sure that you are not around an area where there is fire, because there is fire hazard with oxygen. So make sure there is no fire near the area, and make sure it is not a very closed room. The room should be well aerated, well ventilated. Only then this will take oxygen from the air. It will actually take the air, entire air. It will make it 100%, almost 90 to 95% oxygen. It will remove the nitrogen part. So that is what it does. So this, I think they are giving this service for 24 hours. So meanwhile, when you are arranging a bed or when you are arranging something, then you can use this. Later on, I think they're charging for this. So make sure you use it only till the time you need it. Don't keep it even though your oxygen is maintaining.
How long to use? How long to use?
So this has to be used till, see, suppose you are maintaining at 2 liters, you maintain 95. Then wait for a day, then put 1 liter. Even though he is maintaining for 95, 96, that means probably he is okay. Then you have to switch it off for 1 hour and check the oxygen levels. If he's still maintaining 95, 96 or 97, that means he doesn't need oxygen. That is one thing. That is how you know that the patient is coming off the oxygen. So when do you know that he needs oxygen? That this will help you then. So remember all these points that I told you. This is how you are supposed to use it. Ideally have a power backup, because if there is no power, this will not work. So power should be there. So even if the power is not there for an hour, it's okay. 23 hours per day. You can run it continuously for however long you want until the patient needs oxygen. Don't put high flow. If the patient needs 1 liter, don't put 5 liters, because high oxygen also is not safe. That will also cause some damage. So that is very important. So if you
mask to the, when you put it,
this one.
Mask.
After putting this,
the patient has to.
I didn't understand, sir.
After putting this, the patient has to put mask so that.
So once the patient wears this, like this, he has to put a mask on this. So that means this should be inside and mask should be outside. That is how you have, because you can spread viral particles if you are not wearing a mask. Multiple viral particles will release, billions of viral particles. So be careful, always put a mask, and people around the person also should put a mask. Ideally, that person has to be in a separate room than this thing. So to know if the oxygen is coming or not, you can put it like this. You can feel that air is coming. That means it's running properly. You can put it 4 liters and feel it.